Today, I'm gonna discuss about the Cisco initial configuration dialog. The initial configuration dialog is annoying for engineers, but you are required to know it for the sake of CCNA exam. Once you're an experienced in navigating the Cisco, you'll never use this configuration dialog since you'll know how to configure it manually. However, this is actually quite useful when you ship the device and you need an inexperienced individual to configure the basic connectivity or management. The initial configuration dialog will prompt you when you open a brand new Cisco switch or router, or if you do a write erase command in the privileged mode and reload the device as it erases the contents of the NVRAM. In other words, when there's no startup config located at the NVRAM, the device will prompt you this initial configuration dialog. To enter the initial configuration dialog, just enter yes and then press enter. However, it is up to you if you want to walk through the entire system configuration dialog by typing no at the second prompt. But since we are going to walk through it, you will type yes and then enter. After typing yes, you will be given the options to configure the host names and passwords. First, it will ask you to configure the host name. Hostname is actually the identity of the device, which basically contains information of the device like location or purpose of the device or anything that helps you identify the device. For now, we will just use R1 as hostname. The first password will be the enable secret, which is an encrypted, and it will be used when entering from user mode to privilege mode. You will use a Cisco secret for the password. Another password is the enable password, which is not encrypted and which is used when no enable secret is specified. We will use Cisco password. The third is the virtual terminal password, which is in accessing the router over a network or simply when we're connecting from SSH or Telnet. We will use Cisco BTY. After setting the passwords, we will be prompted to enable the SNMP or the Simple Network Management Protocol, which is an industry protocol to allow device management via API. The SNMP string can be any string. We will use any string. First, we will enter by typing yes, and then we will type the any string. Next, you will be required to configure a single interface which will be used for management of this device. Basically, the interface which is used to connect from the new device to the existing network. Keep in mind that you need to enter the entire name of the interface. We will use the Gigabit Ethernet 00. We just highlight, copy, and then paste. There. Next, it will ask you to configure the IP address. We will just press enter to configure an IP. We will just use the classy private address 192.168.1.2 and press enter. And we will just press enter since we will be using /24 or the 255.255.255.0. Once you've done the setting, the options, the router will show you the script of the changes made in the running config. So this is the changes we made from the running to the running config. Afterwards, it will give you the option to save the configuration, start the setup over again, or disregard the setup information you provided. You will just press enter since we will going to save the configuration to the NVRAM. Now we have to enter from user mode to privilege mode. Since we configure the enable secret password, we will be using Cisco secret. Okay, that's it for the Cisco initial configuration dialog. Thank you for watching my video. Please like my video and don't forget to subscribe for more to get the updated videos. Thank you.